All right, so here I am in Pixlr editor, and I am going to show you how to create a solarization effect, not just in Pixlr, but in any photo editing software where you have access to curves. So I have pulled up a black and white image, and it has fairly strong contrast, and that usually helps when we're in the darkroom, and I think it helps digitally as well. So solarization, just to give you a quick background, is something that we can do in the darkroom by flashing a little bit of light on an image while it is in the developer. So it's a second very brief exposure in the middle of development in the darkroom, which gives us an image that has some parts that look like a positive print and some parts that look like a negative. And to do this in digitally, I'm just going to go to Adjustment here in Pixlr, Curves, and so here I have my curves control. I am going to first double click in the middle to create an anchor point for this, and then I'm going to come over here to the darks. Remember, this is our light side, these are our darks, our whites, our blacks, and I'm going to grab this and I'm going to pull these blacks all the way up. And so now I've turned all my blacks into whites, and you can see that I have an image that has some negative parts, some parts that look like a negative and some parts that look like a positive. I do still want to give myself some stronger blacks, so I'm going to pull this curve down until I get an image that gives me nice rich blacks as well. So I've got this very interesting positive negative effect. Now I can apply this and save it. And now I'm saving. And so I would just download it. I don't want to open it. I just am going to download it. All right, and there's another way that I can do this. So here I've opened up another black and white image. This one of my dog, Mo, because he makes such lovely black and white photographs. And I'm going to show you, sometimes I've found that when an image is a little bit overall, what we would consider an appropriate exposure, but there's a lot of darker tones in this image, I've discovered that it's better to have a little bit brighter image. So I'm just going to use this brightness control here to brighten up the image, because then that's going to give me some I think better results. So there's ways that you can manipulate to apply this solarization. And now I'm going to find my curves again. There we are. And I wanted to show you another way to create this solarization. So again, an anchor point in the middle, bringing the black tones up to white. So this is one way, and I can pull this up or down and kind of do some interesting things. Another thing that might work with some images, and I haven't tried it with this one, is to add two more anchor points, and instead of a U kind of making, come back here, a W kind of an image. So pull one down here, one down here, and that's maybe not quite as interesting, but I was kind of liking this sort of a feel. So I'll take that dot away, and I'll take this dot away, And oh, that does something different again. So you can see that if you play with where you put these dots, like this wants to pull this down, that's kind of cool. But I kind of liked pushing this one up and doing this sort of a thing. So creating a little bit different feel here. I kind of like something like this. So again, you can play with this and see what this kind of thing does for your images. This is just an interesting way to apply what would normally be a darkroom manipulation digitally. And solarization, of course, was used often by early surrealist photographers like Man Ray.